like 40 minutes. You imagine that the worst opponent you ever had is in front of you.
Yeah, he's attacking
him. I don't have a very good imagination.
So, looks like footwork. And that, and defense. You work off the defense. And then you work on your combos. Right? So, come on. So. So, that's what you're doing. You're boxing your shadow. So, keep going. Good. Good. Not here. Here. Affect your ribs. Evening. Good. Good. Small wheel, see? Yeah. So that way, the Muay Thai guy tries to pull this down, it's instinct to pull it back. Yeah. Yeah.
Like a small wheel.
Yeah. Two small wheels in your cheeks, turn them. Yeah, there you go. Yes, sir. How you doing, sir? Yeah, a little bit of rock, a little bit of rope. Feel okay?
Oh, yeah.
I was going to say, you look a little serious.
I always put myself in the plate. I'm stressing myself out,
dude. What you do is you go in thinking like the Joker. Freaks them out.
I know, I tried to.
Damn! Right? Grab your gloves! Oh, my gloves. Oh, yeah. Okay. Nice to meet you.
Sir.
Yeah, what's your name?
Torin.
Torin?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you. All right. Evening, sir. All right. So for our first warm-up round, all right. So we're not going super deep with the first round, but I do want you paying very close attention to the target, okay? So the first round is just teeps, but here's the difference. So on these teeps, you're gonna have a purpose, all right? So when I go to teep, I'm not just teeping, okay? Instead, I'm directing towards either hip, okay? So I'm going to teep to either this hip or that hip, okay? Why would I want to teep to a particular hip?
Off balance.
Off balance, yeah, what else? Yeah, why would I teep to a certain hip? Yeah, yeah, hits the core, yeah. Stuffs the kick. Change stance. Yeah. Force the combo. It forces my combo. If I force him to go into the position I want him to go into, right? So, for example, if I'm here, and let's say I want to kick this leg really hard, maybe I teep to that side so that way it offsets and I can go right in, okay? Or if I, let's say, my southpaw, right? And I don't want to be so exposed on this side, well, I can kick that hip whoop, bam, I can punish that leg now, okay? So there's a multitude of reasons why I might want to do this, but the whole idea is that it's target practice. I'm not just keeping ad hoc, okay? I'm literally picking a target to disrupt something, okay? So I want you to choose a hip or a floating rib. So go back and forth and back and forth. Go kind of soft if you go towards a rib, obviously, because floating ribs tend to get damaged pretty easily. So if you're going towards a rib, be a little bit softer. Maybe I go just, you know, touch, you know. Maybe I don't go too hard on the ribs. Go a little harder on the hips, because that's really, you're going to hurt yourself more than you're going to hurt them on a hip. Okay. So you push back a little more so you can feel that give. Okay. Because remember, if I pop here, that sets me up for all kinds of stuff. And you push them down. If you push hard enough, you can push them right down to a seat. All the weight is now in their legs. I can blast their legs. Right? Again, there's a multitude of ways to disrupt this and make this work for you. But the idea is that you're picking a target. Okay? So left or right, pick a target and then teep it. Do two back and forth. All right? All right. What? All right. Get a partner.
Oh,
single
me out.
All right. How you doing, sir? Come on. I'm going to set you up over here, and I'm going to throw little things at you. And go! Hey, sir. Oh, just triple it with somebody. Okay. Maybe these two guys. We'll probably have... Yeah, we have another one coming in right now. Yeah, and then and we'll have two more come in. They always show up late. Yeah. All right. So, first thing we'll go over is a stance. So, take one small step forward. Right. Your toes always point towards your opponent. Your rear leg is going to be at a 45. Your hips go over top of your foot. Stay tall instead of Muay Thai stance. All right. Bring your arms up, grab your ears, drop your arms down to your ribs, let your hands float to your right to your face. One should be right by your face, the rear one's more close to your face. The front one's going to float in front of your face. So this is more or less what we call kick stance. Right. It's very short, simplified way to look at it. So we always march inside the stance. So go back and forth, back and forth. And then we make small wheel movements with our hands in towards our face. And this right here is our Muay Thai stance. So you stay tall. Think of grabbing a towel and bringing it down. So you pull in just a little bit, and that protects your chin. That's it right there. Yep, very good. Yeah. Remember, keep your hips over the lead leg. There we go. First basic foot movement that I call cross movements. Lead. So your front foot would move first. Rear. Or is that right? Right foot moves first. Left. Left foot moves first. Rear. Rear foot moves first. So... right now, just practice stance and that foot pattern. I'll be back.
All right. I call him. Your bees in the trap. They want the neck. They want it. You can get it from them. No. No. Shouts to Hector. Actually, try and drop it to the floor.
Here you go, sir. How you doing?
Recovering.
Your bees in the trap. You could get it for the low. Shots the heck of it. You should try and drop it to the flow.
Time. All right, next round. Sir. I use you forever. All right, so the next one. So this one, think of it as a kick and stick. All right, kick and stick. So this is actually a fun defensive maneuver. You see it a lot in Muay Thai over in Thailand. You see it a little bit less over here in the States, but it's really effective. So if we're coming here and I go to kick, a lot of times your opponent's going to move in on you, right? What can I do to keep him off of me? Especially if he's a kicker. How do I keep him off of me? Especially if he's a kicker. Cheap, okay. Post, that's good answers. Yeah. What's that? Clinch, all good answers. So this one is a kick and stick, all right? So I kick, he comes in to rush me. And I actually hold this for a second, okay? That push off, yeah. So this is a quick defensive maneuver that keeps the space between you and your opponent, and it sets him up for when I want to kick back again, okay? So again, I'm here, I kick, he steps in, whoop, boom. And I place it right in front of his hips, and I keep my hand out on top of him. And then when I'm ready, I just push off, boom. And now I'm ready to kick again, right away, right? So one more time, I kick, boom, and whoop, bam, I stick, all right? Push off, and I kick again right away, okay? So practice that back and forth. So one, kick, he steps in, post out with your leg, drop in, tap, come back. Now it's his turn, okay? Just back and forth and back and forth. All right, any questions?
They push back.
What's that?
They like push back.
I would absolutely clinch them. Yes, I would. And I would nail a knee on the way in. Yes, I would. All right, okay, go. All right, next one. So, the next one's gonna be pivoting. And when I pivot, all I'm doing is, let's say I wanna pivot in this direction. I will step over, straight back with this leg, and then pivot on the lead. If I wanna pivot in that direction, I step forward and I pivot. Super easy. All I'm doing is just pivoting on the lead leg. I step back a quarter turn. Boom. 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 Make sense?
Sure.
All right, that's your next one.
Trick or cock block, how's it going?
Oh, not bad.
Me on big.
Hey, let's make sure you weren't sick.
Okay, just doing a rear kick.
Oh, so with this one, so it's kick and stick, right? So I'm here, and so like I would kick, and you go to move in on me, boom.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so one, you go to move in, boom. Yep.
Okay.
Yep, so kick, boom, I come in, boom, yeah.
That was it, a cow.
So kick.
Not shun, but the knee kick. The kicking knee.
Take out.
Right?
Take out. Yep. So you kick. Boom, I go a step. You, okay. Yep. But hold it there for a second.
Okay.
And then let go and then kick right behind it. So kick. Come in. Yep. Hold across the hips. So it prevents me from kicking. Good. And then kick right in. Boom. Yeah. So one, two, three. Yeah. Thank you. Good. Perfect. Place it there.
Okay.
Alright. All right. All right, so another one you don't see a lot. Another one you don't see a lot. So now you'll see this again. You'll see this in Thailand a lot, less here. Okay, but now what you're gonna do is I throw a kick, boom, and are immediately blocked right behind it. Why? Obvious, right? It's obvious. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna kick, boom, block, kick. Okay. So I kick, he kicks right behind me, I block, I kick. Okay, like right away. So again, I'm here, I up, up. All right, makes sense? Now you can long block into this as well for extra protection, because I can kick, boom, 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 right? Right behind it. So long block in between this to keep that space so he's not going in for a clinch while you're kicking him, okay? So again, I'm here, I kick, boom, block, boom. Long block in between. Make sense? All right, here we go.
You say the grind in your heart, let me put a different word in it. Spin.
Yeah, zoom in.
Spin it. I'm on my way.
Blocking from the same leg?
Yep, so you're blocking from the rear on this one, okay. But you could block either side.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, and you can join us on this next one. So you're gonna need a pair of gloves. So for the next four rounds are all bag rounds. So what you'll be doing is every 30 seconds, you'll be switching with somebody on the bag. So everyone partners up and you'll be behind somebody. And again, every 30 seconds, you switch. So I'll tell you what you're doing before each round. So easy enough.
Yes, sir.
All right. Be careful, he's a secret ninja.
Only to discover you following Jesus was never meant for the people.
There you go. Good kick. Good kick. Okay. Okay. We're about to be partnering up on the bags in a second.
Okay.
So I might put him behind you because he's new tonight.
These are new gloves. Am I going to need to change the back gloves?
We'll be on bags.
You know what I mean? I'm not going to need to do calisthenics in these.
Oh, there's always push-ups.
All right, well, yeah.
Okay. I'm switching too. Not bad, not bad, good. There you go, good. Turn the hip over a little more. Time! All right. For your first cycle. All right. You will be using the kick and stick. All right, the kick and stick for your first cycle. So I'm on the bag. I kick. I want you placing your leg across the bag. Push back, kick. Start over. Come back in, kick. Yes. Yes. And back out. Okay. Again, I'm here. I kick. Yes. Yes. Come back, reset. All right, so it's how many kicks? Two kicks. But you're posting your leg in between. All right? Control the bag in between. Again. Yes. Yes. All right? Pretty simple. Pretty simple. But it's a balance exercise. So what you're going to find is this part to be hard for you. I want you holding it for a minimum of 2 seconds. A minimum of 2 seconds. So when you come in, yes, one, two, yes. Hold it for 2 seconds. Then kick behind it. Push out, kick behind it. Hold, 2 seconds, kick behind it. It's a balancing exercise. I want you getting used to it. Okay? That's how you control your opponent. Your partner will be out here. I want you practicing long guard into Caldang. I'm sorry, Caldrong. Caldrong. All right, so you're out here. Long guard, come up high. Pay real close attention. This is all about structure. Long guard, come up high in the ball of your foot. I care more about you getting the knee out, so just fold the arm back. I don't even care if you drop this one right now. Okay, but you have to fold this one across your chin. So here, come high. Yes, back. Yes, high. I don't want to see any bent knees. Your leg must remain straight. Yes, yes. All right, lean back. So I shouldn't be here, I should be here. Lean back. All right? All right. Get a partner, get on the bag, or get on the floor. Here we go. Ready! Go! What's that? Oh yeah, so long guard and then drop into long straight, right back again. So the whole idea is that you're maintaining this position and you're right back into long guard. Go! Yeah, so this one you kick. Yeah, and try to angle it so you're flat across there. Good, and then bring your leg up, rest it, let go, and then kick one more time. Yeah, it's a three-part movement. So one, yes, two, three, yes. Switch. Go!
The game went to change while we're
switch.
Now I'm like Pac-Man, that's where the goal score. Cube in the 6-4, Lord knows I've been through. I've been low, boy. My mama playing for the week. Old Jordan, they had the whole house packed like a bed, car rally, shows up and then why woke up.
Good. Hold for 2 seconds. Hold for 2 seconds.
My hand.
Straight across. Yeah. Because you're stopping both hips. Yep. Switch! Yeah, think of it like this. So if I'm here, I laid across here, so now you can't fire either leg.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It actually works more balance. Good. There you go. Good. When you push off, so when you're here, make sure you push off.
Push off.
Yep. There you go, Wheaties. Not bad, not bad. You're getting there. That's good. Yeah. Try angle it across the hips, and then that prevents either leg from getting to you. Yeah. Yep. Yep. Yeah, so angle. Yeah. Yep. And this one, you're firing that knee straight up, so you're pushing your hip with the knee right back. Yeah. So your long guard, so lead arm comes out, and you drop back in the knee, come up high on the ball of your foot, boom, right back out. Yeah. Now hold it. You want to hit them right through. Boom. Go! Nice, there you go. Good job. Better. There you go, that was better. Good. Make sure you fold over your chin. Protect your chin. Go! Good. Try to angle it across the back.
All right, so
on. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Good. You got it, sir. Nice. Good kick. There you go. Try to nail the stop right after the kick.
Like the sucking kick?
Yeah. Yeah, right there. Yep, good. Because that's when they're going to stuff you. Time! All right, next cycle. All right, so just like we were just doing. You're gonna kick, block, kick. Just come back, reset. And, yes, come back. Now, you can block to either side, and we are using our rear leg to block on this one. Why are we practicing blocking with the rear leg?
Sorry, say it again.
Why are we practicing blocking with the rear leg today?
Usually the lead is already conditioned.
All right, good answer. What else? Faster counter, yes. This leg's already in motion. This leg's already in motion, okay? But here's another key thing. Why else, and you're not gonna think about it more than likely, why else would I use the rear leg? Attack position. Sir. So, if I'm here and I kick and I block, I can step right in and I can take away the space that's between us. So, by practicing blocking with the rear, it actually opens up a new attack path. All right, because I'm here and I hop, shh, block, shh. Now I can step right into it and force all of my leverage right through him. Okay, so not only does it give me a different way to block, it offers a different way to attack. All right, so keep that in your head for later in the week. So again, I'm here, okay? Yes, yes! You can block on either side, I don't care which one it is, because we can block with left or right on the rear leg. All right, all right. So pretty simple. On your calisthenic, you'll be going from lunge to kick. That's it, lunge to kick. Super easy, barely an inconvenience. Ready! Go! Good. Try to get nice and deep in your lunge. There you go. There you go. Good, good. Yeah. When you hit that, all you're doing is you're teeping through whatever your target is. So a teep is not like there's a snap kick. It's a push kick. It's like a thrust kick. Yeah. Hey! Switch! Go! Good, get that up. Good. Try to snap it up a little faster so it's good. Switch. Oh. Go. Nice. Good job, D'Angelo. There you go. There you go. Nice, Dylan. There you go. There you go. Nice, nice. Switch! Go!
Just my leg, like when I'm landing like this, it's like front leg kick from here.
Yeah, so if you're hit, it's like.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Nice. Good, Tristan. Good, Dan. Good. Switch! Go! Nice. And then try to turn your hip over a little bit. Feel more power. Nice. There you go. Good. High on the ball of your foot. ball, higher than the ball of your foot. Switch! Go! Nice, good, good, good. Good. Treat the block almost like a double kick. So it's boom. There you go. Much better, much better. Switch. Go. Good there, Brandon. Good job. Good. Treat the block almost like a kick. So that you come in and it's boom, boom, and then right afterwards. There. Much better. Much better. Good, good. Time. All right. All right, this next one, you're going to play a game with the bag. All right. So, I call this teep to spin. Okay, so, like we were doing earlier on our partner's hips, you're going to kick one side of the bag, make it spin, then keep running, come right back up and make it stop. All right. Think of it like a double kick, but a teep. So it's, all right, okay, right away. Try to get it to spin, try to get it to stop. Okay, pop, 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 pop. Double teep, right? So you spin, boom, stop, boom, right away. Spin, stop, spin, stop, spin, stop. I want you to use the front teep, the lead teep. Why lead teep? Anybody? It's quicker. It's
quicker,
it is.
Sometimes we ain't got the hand, so we gotta keep them away.
Yeah, for defense, it's far faster, okay? Because if you're Muay Thai, what's your weight distribution? 60-40, yep. So I have about 60%, even though I'm on the ball of my foot, about 60% is on the rear leg, so I can quickly block, right? Right? So make it quick and snappy. So yeah, I want all these teeps on the lead leg. Lead leg. All right? All right. So remember, teep to spin, teep to stop. Teep to spin, teep to stop. I don't care what side of the bag you're hitting. Teep to spin, teep to stop. All right? Little game you're going to play with yourself in the bag. Your buddy will be on calisthenics, moving push-ups. Go up over about three. Work your way back. Make sense? All right, here we go. Ready?
I was lost and didn't know where to go.
Go! There you go. Now you hand it off. One to spin, one to stop. There you go. Now stop it. There you go. Good, good. Yep. See, spin, boom, stop. Spin, whoop. Spin, whoop, stop. Spin, stop. Spin, stop. Switch! Go!
Trying to get 90 and now they look at me sideways. GOD, my girl a fan, that's top three like my space.
Switch!
First seat that we're doing, are we just kind of touching it or are we pushing
through? You hit the side.
I know, but are we pushing through?
You're pushing through the side of it to make it spin.
Okay, in practice, right? Like, would that first one be a setup for the second one?
Or yes.
Okay.
Think of it this way. Think of it this way. So if I was here, I would be going boom, boom.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm making you melt into your stance so you can't kick me, and then I keep you again.
Okay.
Yeah. There you go. Good, good. Switch. Go. There you go. Good. Good. Yes. Keep the side and keep it stopped. Yeah. And then, like I said, your hips stay over top of your lead leg. That way, I don't have to lift myself to kick. I'm already here. I'm just pop. See? Pop. Now, there you go. Switch! It takes some getting used to because naturally you want to tilt forward a little bit.
Yeah.
So it takes some getting used to stay over the top of your hips.
You play hockey, so I'm used to it.
Yeah. Go!
Question.
Yes.
Why don't you like that old school Thai stance with the more horizontal back foot?
For
you usually have me go like run with the runner stance.
Yes.
You don't like this way.
Rear heel up.
You don't like.
No. You know why I don't like that?
Why?
Where'd you just go?
Back.
That's the point.
Okay.
So anytime this happens, I just want a point.
Okay.
If that rear heel is up, it's forward momentum. It's harder for you to push it back.
Okay. Yeah. I have a harder time keeping it 60-40 doing it this way then.
I know. Takes practice. We all get used to that. But if you start looking at some of the really good Muay Thai fighters, almost all of them keep that rear heel up a little bit. And that's why it's harder for you to break my structure.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Switch! Go!
I'm tall enough. Got it. Oh, there we go. Oh, shit. Oh, one more.
Slip back down, that's why.
Go ahead.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay.
All right. Switch! Much better. Darn boxers. Go! All right. So this next one, last cycle, by the way, last cycle. You'll be starting inside long guard. And you'll be starting with one of your knees up. Now, here's the thing. I don't care which one it is, if it's rear or if it's lead. You're starting with one of them up. You can go back and forth. That's fine. But you're starting with long guard, one up. You want to step down into it and go right in to skip knee. Okay? So you're here. You're starting here. You come in. Back off. You go right back in. So, first off, that is a block. Second, you're stepping into the knee. You're making it strong. That's a hard knee, okay? So every time you do this, remember you are blocking, and you're stepping in to that knee. You're making all of that weight guide into your opponent. So make it a hard knee, and then launch your skip knee from there. Start again. Make sense? All right. Your partner will be out here. Didn't do burpee. So you're down, come up, pop your legs in, go up, right back down the triangle. Don't overcomplicate this. Come down the triangle, Hindu push-up. Bring your knees up, pop, back down the triangle. It's pretty simple once you get a hang of it. Triangle, knees in, pop. Triangle, knees in. Make sense? All right, here we go. Last cycle. Go! Switch. Go. Switch. Whee! Go. There you go. Drop down. Boom. Good. Sharp knees. Good. Get sharp knees. Boom. Yeah, there you go. Go! Good. And push back a little bit, then drop on your knee. Yeah, push straight back. Right there. Yep, and then release and then knee into it as it falls. Yep, and then push. See? Watch. Push back, then fall, push, fall, push, fall. Yeah. It gives you that feeling so that way. This means you're conditioning for a clinch. They push, right? Boom, push. Boom. Go! There you go. Good. Push back on the bag. Let the bag fall into you. See? boom, push back, boom, push back, boom. See?
You're not pulling back at all?
You can, but here's the thing. I don't have to, but I want to. Watch. I comes down, boom, boom, boom. I'm using gravity.
It doesn't feel like a ball of grass.
Switch! Yeah. Watch. Push back. Now I let it fall to me. Shh, push. Shh. Shh. Good. Let gravity help you. Back. Boom. Let that gravity feed and let it come towards you. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Switch. Good. Let gravity feed it. Push up. Watch this. Push up. And then let it come to your knee. Boom. Push back. Boom. Sit. Boom. Boom. Each time I'm letting gravity feed.
So real quick. All right. You can go ahead. So you're going to play bag for a second, okay? So
okay.
Here. Nice. Yep. Step in. Boom. Okay.
Yep.
And if it's this side, I can still come with my right arm.
You're still using a lead. Always use lead. Because anytime you're not using a lead, you're exposing your chin. Yeah. So if I was here, I'd be here. See?
Yeah.
Here, here.
So switch stance, same thing? Sure.
Yeah. Switch! Go! So, start. Boom! It looks hard, it's easy. Watch. Push against it and let it come to you. Yeah. Push, feed, push, feed, push, feed. Time! Everyone, gloves on! Gloves on! You still have lunch on! Gloves on real quick! Let's go, let's go, let's go! So it's lunch on, super light, touch sparring, super light touch sparring. All you need is gloves, you don't need any other gear, all right? Super light. So, real quick. So if I'm here, literally no more than 2% power. Boom, 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 boom. It gives us a chance to practice everything we just did, but without the fear of getting hit in the face and a broken nose, okay? So super light. See that? Super light, all right? All right. Grab a partner. You'll be switching every 1 minute. Ready? Here we go. Go! Gums curling my mouthpiece. Thank you. Switch. Switch and go! Yeah.